Senator Robin Padilla finds it laughable. The police may file an obstruction of justice charge against former President Rodrigo Duterte. The police earlier said they may press charges after Duterte claimed he knew the whereabouts of his fugitive spiritual advisor, Apollo Quiboloy. The televangelist is wanted on charges of human trafficking and sexual abuse. But Senator Padilla believes Duterte was merely joking.
Hindi mo nga alam kung nagbibiro yung tao o seryoso. Siguro ang pwede nilang hingin dyan, hingan nila si ex-president ng sabihin na ano ba yung official statements. Ano ba official statement nyo? Kasi baka nagbibiro lang yung tao.
The Philippine Justice Department says it will process a police complaint against Duterte if it's filed.
We leave it up to the law enforcement agencies to evaluate muna kung ano yung sa tingin niya sa tingin nila the possible actions that they can take on the statements of the former president. But on the part of the DOJ, again, we will wait for any complaint that is filed with the department before we act on it.
The Philippine military appeals for calm following rumors of an imminent missile attack from China. AFP Chief General Romeo Browner says they are still in the process of verifying the claims of the president's sister, Senator Aimee Marcos. He adds the military is looking to beef up critical facilities to deter and withstand potential attacks.
Wala pa ho kaming nakikita na report to this effect na merong 25 targets. We will be, of course, coordinating not just with a good senator, pero sa lahat po ng may mga information na ganito. No? Dahil, siyempre, gusto po natin makita lahat po ng impormasyon nang sa gayon ay matugunan po natin itong mga ito. No? Meaning, we will plan according to the information that we gather. Ang pakiusap lang po namin is that if possible, yung ating mga kababayan po ay huwag magpanik, no? Huwag magpanik dahil sa mga information na ito.
Beijing also rejecting the claim of Senator Marcos, saying China possesses no threat to any other country.
I don't know where the information claimed by the Philippine side came from. What I can tell you is that China adheres to the path of peaceful development, pursues a defensive national defense policy, and poses no threat to any country. Of course, we will never sit back and watch our legitimate rights and interests and regional peace and stability being violated and threatened. We urge the countries concerned to face up to the concerns of their own citizens and the voices of the countries in the region, to safeguard the fundamental interests of their own people and to insist on independence and autonomy.
The National Security Council has also dispelled the statement of Senator Marcos, but it says it would still coordinate with the senator to get more information about her claim. The Philippine Armed Forces also warning against China's supposed infiltration of Philippine media and local governments. AFP Chief General Romeo Browner Jr. says Beijing is using a so-called United Front Work strategy where it is targeting key sectors to gain entry and gather information on the Philippines. He adds China is also beefing up its propaganda by spreading false information. Manila has been intensifying its transparency campaign on the West Philippine Sea in a bid to expose Beijing's maritime aggression.
Ang pangontra po natin dito sa mga United Front Works nila is that we are going to try to gather information from all of this, and then we're going to give the proper agency the right kind of information. For instance, yung ginawa po natin mga operations against the POGO, no? Hindi naman po yung POGO mismo, kasi may mga lisensyado, may mga legal na POGO. Ang rini-raid po natin ay yung mga illegal na mga establishments. Yung mga dating POGO na legal, bigla na lang naging illegal because of other activities that they are doing within the confines of their structures.
China appears to be rejecting the Philippines' demand for Beijing to pay for the damage it caused during last month's tense encounter in Ayungin Shoal. The Philippine Armed Forces said it is seeking 60 million pesos from China for damaging the country's military equipment and for the medical operations of the Navy personnel who lost his finger during the incident. But Beijing only responded by saying Manila must face the consequences of its own action. It also asserted its move was only meant to defend China's sovereignty from what it called violators. Despite this, the Philippines vows to respond accordingly to China's bullying tactics.
Nung sinabi kong lalaban tayo, ang ibig ko sabihin po doon ay hindi natin hahayaan na basta na lang ibuli tayo ng ganun, no? Katulad nung nakaraan niya, of course, may mga dalang mga armas yung ating katunggali. But in the next rore, ay basta hindi po tayo papayag na basta na lang, no? Apihin. For instance, kung gumamit po siya ng kutsilyo, gagamit rin tayo ng kutsilyo, no? Hindi po yung lalabis, hindi lalabis dun sa, hindi po umatake siya, hindi po natin siya babarilin.
Hollywood superstar Leonardo DiCaprio asks President Marcos to protect the Masungi Geo Reserve in the Masungi Geo Reserve in Rizal Province. Rafael Busano has the story.
No less than Hollywood actor and environmentalist Leonardo DiCaprio called on President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to protect the Masungi Geo Reserve. In a post on Instagram, he says that the success of efforts to restore the ecosystem is in jeopardy because of the Department of Environment and Natural Resources' threats to cancel an agreement which aims to protect Masungi from land-grabbing activities.
Climate change, the biodiversity crisis, is actually a global issue, with the Philippines being one of the most mega-diverse countries in the world and also the most affected by climate change. Tayo yung tinitingala at tinitingnan ng buong mundo, no, kung paano natin i-handle yung ganitong kaimportanteng mga lugar tulad ng Masungi Geo Reserve at ng Masungi Geo Park Project.
The DENR has earlier recommended the cancellation of a memorandum of agreement with Masungi Geo Reserve Foundation because of a provision they deem as unconstitutional. In a statement, the agency says that while it appreciates the support of celebrities to the country's environment, no one is exempt from the law. It adds that the Filipino people own Masungi and that operations that charge fees for tours, meetings, and even weddings are against the law, something which MGF denied doing.
All the proceeds from conservation fees are used for the furtherance of the mission of the foundation, which is the conservation of the limestone landscape. Ano ba sinasabi nila? Pinagkikitaan namin, di ba? Wala. Ano? Public lahat ng financial documents namin. Binigay na nga sa kanila. Ano pang gusto nilang sabihin namin?
Dumaliang Challenge Environment Secretary Maria Antonia Yulo Loizaga to visit Masungi herself to see where conservation fees actually go. This isn't the first time that international personalities lent their voices to Masungi. Renowned conservationist Dr. Jane Goodall, climate justice activist Greta Thunberg, and rock icon Sting also called on the public to protect the environment. The Masungi Geo Reserve is known to help lower high temperatures and mitigate flooding in some areas. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Let's now get an update on the weather from Pagasa forecaster Anna Claren Horda.
Yes, good morning, Bettina. The Intertropical Convergence Zone, or ITCZ, is now affecting southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. And this will bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms here in Metro Manila, Calabar Zone, Mimaropa, Bicol Region, Visayas, and Zamboanga Peninsula. Meanwhile, the easterlies will continue to bring light to moderate rains over Aurora and Quirino. While the rest of the country, we're expecting a partly cloudy to cloudy skies aside from isolated rain showers, mostly in the afternoon or in the evening due to localized thunderstorm. currently, we're not monitoring any weather disturbance that may affect the country for the next 3 to 5 days. And over the weekend here in Metro Manila, expect a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers in the afternoon or in the evening. And that's the latest from Pagasa. This is Anna Clorene Horda. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna.